Pinch row compaction is likely crushing your yields, especially if you use a central fill planter to put your crop in the ground. Soil compaction from your tractors, tires, and planters' tires can stunt root development and eventually cause yield loss across your fields. We wanted to see if switching the planter and planting tractor from standard radials to VF radials would recover some of that yield loss by literally taking some pressure off the soil. When designing this study, we partnered with an area farmer to outfit his two identical four-wheel drive tractors and planters with different sets of tires. One tractor and planter wore standard radials, while the second tractor and planter sported VF radials, which provide a larger footprint at lower inflation pressures. If you're not familiar with the term, VF stands for very increased flexion. This designation tells us that the tire can be run at 40% less air pressure than a standard radial tire, while carrying the same load. Would the planting setup with VF tires provide a yield advantage over the standard radial setup? That's what we wanted to learn. During our study, we also confirmed a few more benefits of VF tires. One of these benefits really stood out to the farmer we partnered with, and he now has VF tires on all of his planters and planting tractors. Now, we probably don't need to tell you that center fill planters are extremely heavy when loaded with seed and fertilizer, and when folded for transport, they hang an enormous amount of weight on the tractor's rear axle. To carry this load without damaging your tires, you have to run your tires at higher than ideal air pressures on both the tractor and planter. This reduces the tire's footprint size, which translates to increased pressure on the soil when working in the field. And as we know from numerous studies, soil compaction hurts your yields. Now, this wasn't a perfect study because the VF tractor and the standard radial tractor wore different tire brands. And due to differences between the brands, not every tire on the VF tractor and planter setup was set to 40% lower air pressure than the standard radials on the other setup. Some pressures were only decreased by about 20%. Once we outfitted the equipment, we sent both tractors and planters to the same field. We planted one cornfield and one soybean field with alternating passes, which gave us a 750-acre side-by-side comparison. In addition to observing yield differences months later, we made some other discoveries during the test that may convince you to invest in VF tires for your operation. As it turns out, the ride quality improvement on the tractor wearing VF tires was the biggest surprise of the test. The farmer we partnered with has a lot of road miles to travel each year, and he was blown away by how much smoother the ride was with VF tires. Our farmer also used both test tractors on grain carts for fall harvest. As you know, grain cart driving can exact a toll on your body as you bounce across the fields at high speed between the combine and the trucks in an effort to keep the whole operation rolling. When carting with the VF tires, our farmer noticed that the ride quality was again far superior to the standard radial setup. In fact, the farmer said that the improvement in ride quality alone would justify the cost of upgrading to VF tires for his operation. Ride quality wasn't the only improvement we saw with the VF tires. Using John Deere's machine analyzer feature, we were able to compare performance metrics such as wheel slippage and fuel consumption between the two tractors. This chart shows the amount of time the tractor spent at specified slippage levels. As you can see, the tractor wearing VF tires spent more time between 0 and 2% slippage and less time working in the 2 to 10% range. Overall, the tractor equipped with VF tires experienced 13% less slippage than the tractor equipped with standard radials. That brings me to fuel economy. Once again, the tractor wearing VF tires outperformed the radial equipped tractor by an impressive margin. During our test, the tractor wearing standard radials burned an average of 15.7 gallons of fuel per hour, while the tractor with VF tires consumed 14.2 gallons of fuel per hour on average. Therefore, we saw a fuel economy improvement of almost 10% on the tractor equipped with VF tires. Now we've come to the big question we asked at the beginning of our study. Does planting with VF tires recover some of the yield loss growers experience from pinch row compaction? The answer is yes, but it's not quite that cut and dried. So let me explain a little further. Over areas of the field that are poorly drained, the wetter spots, the VF tires provided a small yield advantage. Through the portions of the field that are well drained and dry throughout the year, the standard radial tires actually delivered a slight yield advantage. In both cases, the yield advantage was small, only a couple bushels per acre either way. When we averaged the results out over all 750 test acres, both planting setups resulted in roughly the same yields. In 2020, the weather during the growing season was nearly perfect, and farmers in the area saw record yields. Some products, such as the VF tires we tested, had a much smaller ROI in these ideal conditions than they would have had in a more typical year. Let's recap what we've learned through this study. The VF tractor and planter tires provided a noticeably better ride in the field and on the road. We measured 13% less slippage and a 9.6% savings in fuel with the VF tires over the standard radial tires. But in 2020, we saw no field-wide yield advantages with the VF tires on corn and soybeans. However, the data seems to indicate that there could be more yield potential when planting and growing conditions are wetter than ideal. At this point, you might be asking yourself, will it pay to outfit my planting tractor and planter with VF tires? Truth is, it's hard to answer that question without taking into account the unique scope of your farm. The advantages of VF tires will vary from year to year and from operation to operation. The number of acres you run, the size of the equipment you use, and the geography of your farm will all influence how a VF tire upgrade would impact your operation. I can tell you that the farmer who partnered with us to conduct this study decided that upgrading to VF tires was worth the money. He bought the tires he ran this past season and has already upgraded his other two planters and four-wheel drive tractors with VF tires as well. If you have questions about the study or about which tires are best for your operation, you can talk with an expert at NTS Tire Supply by going to ntstiresupply.com. We'll find the best fit in tires and wheels for your equipment and budget to help make you the best farmer. And of course, if you found this video helpful, please give us a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, and let us know in the comments which tire comparison you'd like us to do next. Thank you for watching, and we will see you in the next video.